thought the Lord put on my mind this morning is Mark this year. Mark this year. Let's pray. Father, Lord, we just thank you, Lord, for all you've done for us. We thank you, Lord, that you've been good to us, Lord. And Lord, we look to you, Lord. You're the author and you're the finisher of our faith. Pray for those who are going through, Lord, even as you're able, Lord, to help us realize that all things work together for good to them that love the Lord, who are called according to his purpose. What we don't understand, give us grace, Lord. Give us grace, because we know your grace is sufficient. Now bless all of us. Bless your word. As John said, I must decrease, but he must increase. Have your way. We surrender to you. Give us strength where we weak. Give us power where we lack. We surrender to your spirit. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. Mark this year. Amen. This way we're going to look at Mark is defined in this instance. There's a lot of ways you can define Mark as a target, a goal. Aim at the mark. Amen. And while I was meditating this morning, another thought came to me. You can even mark stuff by writing it down. Amen. But we want to take aim at some stuff this year. Amen. We want to hit the bullseye. Amen. I start to call the team and tell them to give me a bullseye up there with all my points, but it was too late. It was too late. Amen. But we have some things that we don't write them down. Or you need to probably write them down. And people do make what? Resolutions and amen and all that good stuff. We make resolutions, but we need to aim at something this year. Set your goal high. You may not reach it, but you will put on muscle climbing toward it. How many know we need some high goals? I mean, spiritually, we need to aim high. I like Bishop Jones. I think that's Bishop Jones who wrote, deeper, deeper, yet I pray. Amen. We need to grow deeper this year. Amen. On that bullseye, we need to get closer to the center. I mean, you know, it's hard sometimes to throw that dart right in the middle. Amen. Perhaps because you got nervous hands. I don't know what your problem is, but amen. But every now and then, you'll miss the whole board. I don't know what the problem is then, but this year we don't want nobody to take our aim and miss the whole board. Yeah. Amen. But we want you to set your goal high and aim at those things that can promote your spiritual growth. Yeah. Amen. I like that song say, we are climbing Jacob's ladder, and every round goes what? Higher and higher. Amen. Oh, I love that song. Do you think I'll make a soldier? Amen. I would sing, but I ain't got my singing voice this morning. Y'all better be glad this morning. I just got enough to preach, but if I can sing, do you think I'd make a soldier? Amen. We are climbing Jacob's ladder. Goals are dreams with deadlines. How many know we ain't going to have forever to hit the mark? Time is winding up, but 2018, we want to hit the mark. Amen. I want to be the same I was last year. Amen. I want to get smacked around by Satan like I did last year. Amen. But I want to be strong in the Lord, in the power of his might. Mark this year, the great apostle Paul wrote this letter to the church at Philippi. And they were a church that he endeared himself to. Amen. This was a church, he really liked this church at the Philippian church. Paul was sitting in prison, remembering their care and support. His heart swelled up with joy and with thanksgiving for them, and he thanked God for them. First of all, we should mark the year with thanks. How many know we need to be more grateful people? We need to be more thankful people. The Bible said, enter into his gates with thanksgiving and into his courts with praise. Be thankful unto him and bless his name, for the Lord is good. His mercy is everlasting and his truth endureth to all generations. We ought to know he's a good God. Paul thanked them for their support. You know it's good to be supported. And when people support you, you ought to say thank you. But this year, we ought to thank God. Amen. We ought to learn to thank God for whatever's going on. Colossians 1:12 said, giving thanks unto the Father which had made us meet to be partaker of the saints in light. How many know we somebody? Peter said, we are a chosen generation. We are a royal priesthood. We are a holy nation that we should show forth the praises of him who called us out of darkness into his marvelous light. I know I misquoted that. It's good anyway. But we are somebody. We are peculiar people. Amen. We ain't strange. Amen. We ought to thank God. I'm glad I'm a soldier. I'm glad I'm in the army of the Lord. I'm glad that he chose me too. How many that since Christ has chosen us? How many know God chose us? Paul said, according as he has chosen us in him before the foundation of the world, that we should be holy and without blame before him in love. Amen. I can't count on thanks. Another verse said, and let the peace of God rule in your hearts, to which also you are called in one body, and be ye thankful.
That's right.
Amen. God wants us to hit the bullseye of thanksgiving. Amen. If you complained too much last year, say, Lord, I don't want to complain. Amen. I can't complain. Amen. Y'all know that song. That's, every time I say that, I can see the old sister singing. I can't complain. Or whatever. They'll sing it. Amen. I told y'all to have my singing voice. But, amen, if you've been complaining too much, give God thanks. On the streets of London, the great preacher Charles Spurgeon was robbed. When he arrived home and told his wife, he said, thank the Lord anyhow. His wife said so much, what? Thank the Lord anybody, anyhow. Why should you thank the Lord? And they stole your money. He said, no, my dear. First, I thank God the robber just took part of my money, not my life. Second, I thank the Lord I had left most of my money home, and he didn't really rob me of much. Thirdly, I'm thankful to God that I was not that robber. Amen. In everything, give thanks. Paul thanked that church, for Paul gave thanks for that great church in Philippians. Then we need to hit the mark of prayer. Amen. It's coming up. We heard a lot of it earlier about we need to pray. Paul said that he always prayed for the church. Sharpen your prayer life this year. Get intimate with God. Amen. How many know we need to get down to business with God? Amen. That's why I like individual prayer. I can talk to God. See, I ain't got to be worried about a certain posture, or I ain't got to be worried about who looking at me, or what words I might not say right. You know, I start practicing praying out loud. Amen. Just praying out loud. Amen. Sharpen your prayer life. How many know we can be great prayer warriors? Amen. We got to be careful that we don't give God the time in prayer like we should. Romans, great scripture, 8:26 says, likewise, the Spirit helpeth all infirmities, for we know not what we should pray for as we ought. But the Spirit itself make intercession for us, which groanings which cannot be uttered. Amen. Don't get afraid of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Let the Spirit have his way. When you're by yourself, anything might happen. Amen. You know, you need to get down to business with God. Oh, amen. That Lord, lay me down to sleep. That may work a little bit. Amen. But your prayer ought to be richer than that. Amen. You ought to thank God, and we ought to pray. 1 Chronicles 16:11 said, seek the Lord and his strength. Seek his face continually. How many know we like seasons of prayer? Amen. When it's tough times, we pray more intense. Amen. But when things are going good, we sort of lay it down a little bit. You know, man, I got this, you know. I got this under. But how many know we should pray more intensely all the time? Amen. We don't know what a day may bring forth. Amen. And there's something to them. I got my prayers stored up. That's good. But I need to pray, give us this day my daily prayer. I need to pray to God anyway. Amen. That song, that quote says, what? Little prayer, little problem. Some prayer, some power. Much prayer, much power. Amen. We need to pray this year. Amen. Hit that mark. Amen. I got my dart thing out. Hit that mark of prayer. Hit the bullseye. Amen. Don't throw the dart and get off the board. Amen. But if you get off the board, pick that dart back up and say, I'm going to hit the mark. Don't let Satan have you give up. Amen. Pray, pray, and pray. Matthew said, ask and it shall be given. Seek and ye shall find. Knock and it shall be open. Prayer is not overcoming God's reluctance, but cooperating with his willingness. Amen. I learned to just, I'm going to cooperate with God. God, I wanted to take that turn, but now God said, you can't take that turn. Amen. I got to get in step with God. That great book, In His Steps. We got to get in step with God. Amen. Daniel chose rather to spend the night in the lion's den than go through the day without prayer. Amen. He was really hitting that mark. Amen. He hit the mark. Amen. He said, I ain't going to bow. I ain't going to give up my prayer. Amen. Now, you know, that's some kind of boldness. Daniel chose. That song, that great song said, oh, what peace we often forfeit. Oh, what needless pain we bear. All because we do not carry everything to God in prayer. And prayer is not just a list and all that, and we say we request. How many know we pray we can love on God? Oh, Lord, I love you, Lord. Amen. Don't get me started now. Amen. We need to get down to business with God. Amen. This is your relationship with God. This is our relationship. But this is your one-on-one time with God. Amen. We need to know that Christianity is a one-on-one experience. Yes, it is. Yes, it is. I got to walk this thing out. Yes. I got to work this thing out. Paul said, work out your own salvation with fear and trembling. Yes. Amen. We meet the mark with thanks, mark with prayer, mark with joy. Look what he says here. Paul in prison, man in prison, yet his heart is filled with joy. That's right. For that Philippian church. Joy means chara. It means happiness, inner gladness, proper attitude toward life. Joy of the world is temporary. It depends on what's happening. Amen. But the joy that we have from God is a divine joy. Galatians 5:25 says, the fruit of the Spirit is love, and here shows up joy. Joy shows up. It's what the Holy Spirit will give you. This joy I have, that old song said, the world didn't give it to me, and the world, what? It can't take it away. Joy springs forth from faith. Romans 15:13 says, now the God of hope fill you with joy.
That's right.
Oh, do you believe in him today? God will give you joy where there's sadness. God will give you joy this morning. Joy, a future reward. Hebrew writer 12:2 said, looking unto Jesus, the author and the finisher of our faith, who for the joy that was set before him. How many know it's going to be some more joy? Amen. If you don't catch joy down here, it's going to be joy on the other side. But I thank God that he dropped some joy down here. I ain't got to wait till I get to heaven. Amen. But I can shout right now. How many know the joy of the Lord is our strength? Weeping may endure for the night, but what joy comes in the morning? Amen. God has promised us that he will give us joy. My Romans 14:7 said, the kingdom of God is not meat and drink. Yeah. Amen. It's not me partying and Lord love me to have some good dinners. But that's not the kingdom of God. It's not meat and drink, but it's righteousness, it's joy, and it's peace in the Holy Spirit. Amen. God to give us that inner satisfaction, a proper attitude toward life. Amen. Paul had joy for that church. Amen. They gave him joy and he gave them joy. It was a mutual thing. He loved that Philippians church. Amen, amen. We need to love one another. Amen. I wait till I get to love now. Amen. We got a few more before we get to love. Number four. Amen. Before we move there, the fellowship. Joy is not the absence of trouble, but the presence of Christ.
Hallelujah.
I couldn't let that one go.
That's right.
We are troubled on every side. Paul said, but we are not in distress. We are perplexed, but not in despair. How many know it's Christ in you? It's the hope of glory. He'll give you joy on the inside. L.P. Jack said, Christianity is the most joyous, the least repressive of all the religions of mankind. While it has its sorrows and stern discipline, the end of it is a resurrection, not a burial. A festival, not a funeral. How many know we're going to have something to look forward to? When we die, we are just transition. He said, flesh and blood shall not inherit the kingdom of God. This mortal must put on immortality. Paul said, we shall be changed. Oh, I love that. I ain't going to have this old body racking with pain. I can't jump because my knees hurt. I ain't gonna have this old body. I can't remember like I used to remember. But we shall be changed. In a moment, in a twinkling of the eye. No more hospitals. No more doctor visits. No more prescription medications. But we shall be changed. I have a new body. Oh, I feel the Good News Club. I'm going to heaven and I can't wait. Going to see Jesus and I can't wait. And I know I'll not be late because I'm going to heaven and I can't wait. I'm going somewhere. There'll be joy every day. Amen. Joy is not a luxury or a mere accessory to the Christian life. It is a sign that we are really living in God's wonderful love. And that love satisfies us. I got carried away on joy. Amen. Number four, fellowship. Amen. I know I was going to get broke down on some of them. Fellowship. Amen. The koinonia. That's the Greek word. I love them Greek words. Can't say them, but I love them. Koinonia. Amen. It's something like that. Amen. It's close enough. The source of fellowship is the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ. We Christians have a spiritual bond, a spiritual union, because we have experienced the same salvation and embraced the same faith.
Yeah.
Amen. That's the fellowship he's talking about. Amen. We always sing that song, oh, what a fellowship. Oh, what a joy divine, leaning on the everlasting arm. We share in the things of Christ. Amen. How many know we share in the things? Tony Evans said of koinonia, or fellowship, biblical fellowship concerns itself not with cookies and punch in a fellowship hall. help us, Lord.
That's right.
Or social gatherings where you have it, or social gatherings. Authentic biblical fellowship means the mutual sharing of the life of Christ between his family members. The cookies and punch, that's okay. That ain't the issue there, you know?
Right.
Amen. It's us heartfelt fellowship because we all are part of God's kingdom.
Right.
How many know we are family?
Right.
Amen. How many know families have a good time?
Right.
Amen. They be tripping, but they still have a good time, man. Sometimes folk in the church start tripping, but you can look past that. Amen. It's a thing, and this Bible said, and let us, Hebrews said, and let us consider one another to provoke unto love and to good works. It said, not forsaking the assembly of ourselves together as the manner of some is, but exhorting one another so much the more as you see the day approaching. The early apostles, they broke bread together from house to house. Amen. I ain't telling y'all to go to each other's house and break bread, but amen. But we ought to have fellowship. Amen. It ought to be some Bible study groups. And amen. That's what, that's popular thing, the Bible study groups in the home. That's popular.
Amen. Because they people want fellowship. Amen. That song say, no man stands on an island. No matter how a person say, oh, I want to be by myself. I don't want to be around nobody. Amen. That might be okay sometime, but all the time, that probably ain't no good thing. You need to be around somebody that can support you and somebody that can tell you you can make it. I had a bad day, Eric, yesterday, and I tell you, you can make it. I messed up yesterday, and I tell you, just get up and pick yourself up and tell Satan he's a lie and tell him you're going to march on. Fellowship one another. Amen. We'll be able to pick up a person when they're down. Amen. We out, as the Bible say, the strong out to bear the infirmities of the weak. We're moving on. Next, we have confidence. Amen. All these, we know we can preach sermons from any of these. This great scripture. He said, he which hath begun a good work in you. How many know this is a good work? Sometimes we don't act like it's a good work. Amen. But it's a good work. God will complete his good work. He told them, Philippians, God is going to complete his good work. Good work that revolutionized or radically changed the life of believer. How many know we can be changed right down here? We can live, Bible said, for the grace of God that bringeth salvation hath appeared unto all men, teaching us that denying ungodliness and worldly lusts, that we should live righteously, soberly, and godly in this present world. How many know we already making progress? Look at that bullseye and say, I'm confident in you, God. You started this work in me, and I know you're going to complete it. I got some rough edges. Lord, I want you to smooth out my rough edges. I got some things I'm struggling with. But Lord, help me. Lord, I believe. Help thou my unbelief. God is always working on us. Good work completed when Christ comes back. We ain't going to totally be, but we ought to be pressing toward the mark. Amen. We ought to be getting them, not missing the bullseye. But let's, Lord, put us on the board at least. Put me around that round circle. Amen. And every now and then I get a direct hit. Amen. But we need to be growing higher and higher. Said every round grows higher and higher. Paul said, I know in whom I have believed, and I am persuaded that he's able to keep that which has been committed unto him against that day. Oh, I believe he can keep me. Oh, that great Jew said he's able to keep us from falling. Oh, Donnie, he corrected. I heard him correct. He said, we fall down, we get up. Wasn't meant that the Christian life is a struggle. But it was meant to show that if you fall, you can get back up. You don't have to stay down there and waddle in your sin and say, I'm going to go back and go crazy. But you get back up. Say, Satan, you got me off the board, but I'm getting back on the board. Amen. We fall down, but we get back up. Confident in God. Peter said in 1 Peter 1 and 5, we are kept by the power of God through faith, ready to be revealed in the last time. Confident that God is keeping us. I can't keep myself, but God can keep me. Amen. If I surrender and keep my hand in his hand, he can keep me. Amen. We almost getting there. During the first part of the construction of the Golden Gate Bridge in San Francisco, no safety device was used. And 23 men fell to their death. For the last part of the project, however, a large net was used. Net cost about $100,000. And they said at least 10 men fell into the net. And they were saved. But an interesting sidelight is the fact that 25% more work was accomplished when the men were assured of their safety. We're assured of our safety. Get out there and work. Amen. God is there to catch you. Amen. He'll catch you if you fall. He'll catch you if you get out of track some kind of way, and he'll put you right back on the track. The thief coming but to steal, to kill, and to destroy. But Jesus said, I come that you might have life and have it more abundantly. Oh, I have confidence in God. What you gonna put on the, what you gonna mark down? I'm gonna have confidence in God. Lord, I believe in you. Amen. A woman said, I may tremble on the rock, but the rock never trembles under me. Amen. I have confidence in God because I'm standing on the rock. Oh, this song said, on Christ, the solid rock I stand. All other ground is sinking sand. Amen. We almost there now. Mark this year with thanks. Mark this year with prayer. Mark this year with joy. Mark this year with fellowship. Mark this year with confidence. And mark this year with heart. Amen. 7 and 8, Paul held the Philippians dear to his heart. Amen. How many know some Christians don't have much heart? Amen. I won't be too mean today. Some of them are mean as I don't know what. Amen. I know when I was little, man, some of them I would avoid, I tell you. Amen. When I was growing up, some of the saints, I wasn't going to get on them, boy. Amen. But then I got to know a few of them. You know, I ain't going to mention no name. It might be somebody else I can to. Amen. But some, and most of them were sister girls, sisters, I mean. To, amen. Some of the sisters, the older ladies. Amen. I would avoid them at all costs. Because I didn't think they had much heart. Amen. They didn't have much feeling. I say they kind of don't have much feeling there. They ain't going to cross their path. They ain't going to get in their way. But as I got to know them, I saw their heart. Amen. They would pull me aside and do me some favors. Give me a piece of candy or something like that. But they just didn't know how to show it. That mean outer shell. But amen, when you get under the surface, you can see they had a good heart. They love children. Amen. They will fuss at us sometimes, but they love children. Amen. We need to have heart. We need to have, for we have not a high priest which cannot be touched by the feeling of our infirmities. Amen. This year, have heart. Don't be so tough. Amen. And can't nobody, you don't smile, never smile. You don't never smile, but smile sometimes. You know, somebody said, you don't know what I'm going through, but just smile it through. Amen. Some people have tough exteriors. Amen. But we need to have the heart, the innermost feeling, the innermost being. Heart that goes from breast to breast and heart to heart. Amen. We need to have heart to God. You say when God measures a man, he put a tape measure around his heart, not his head. That's right. It's good to be smart, but have some heart. Amen. Look out into the fields, for they are white right into the harvest. The harvest is plentiful. People are dying every day without a Savior. Amen. They used to say we need a heart for the loss. Amen. Lord, give me a heart for the loss. I throw that bullseye. Get me back on the bullseye circle. A lot of us around the circle, we need to get back on the circle. And say, Lord, give me a heart for the loss. People are dying every day. And we just said, oh, well, oh, well. Amen. We need a heart for the loss. Amen. We need a heart to go out and do. Man, body, soul, and spirit. And we have a body, but we have a heart. That's why, like he said, take out that stony heart and give us a heart of flesh. Where we can feel for folk. Amen. Where we could get down and help them out. Amen. There's a lot of stuff in the news about the new police chief. And amen. He called all the preachers together and they want to help out in the community. I mean, you know, the church, we ought to have a heart for the community. We ought not need nobody to rally us around and say, yeah, I know y'all need a little more heart. Y'all need to show a little more compassion. Amen. We need to know we should have a heart for the community. Amen. As we celebrate great Dr. Martin King, it snuck on me fast this year. Amen. I would have done a Black History sermon, but it snuck up on me. But as we celebrate, amen, the great Dr. Martin Luther King, let's remember to have a heart for people. Amen. We almost wrapping. Verse 7, let's move on here. Let's move on. I ain't giving y'all all my good illustrations. Y'all have to come back for part two. Y'all have to come back for part two. Amen. We need to mark this year with what? Love.
Amen. And I ain't got to say a lot about love. Agape love, 1 Corinthians love. Paul wants the believers' love to grow more and more. You know, I ain't no grow. Yeah, yes, I did. I was going to say I ain't no love could grow. But your love can grow.
Yes, it can. Yes, it can.
Amen. I mean, no love can grow.
Right.
You know, I love you a little bit. Now I love you a little bit more. No, love grow. Amen. He said here, Paul said, we will approve, discern the things that are excellent. Paul said he wants your love to grow, to approve and discern the things that are excellent. Paul said he wanted to live pure lives. Love him and keep his commandments. You know, that's how love grow. If we love God, we'll keep his commandments. Love will grow. Amen. And we ought to want to do right because it pleases God. We ought to want to do right because it displeases God when we do wrong. Amen. Oh, yeah, you may be able to get by with it, but you know you ain't going to get away in the long term. The Bible said, whatever you sow, you're going to reap. That great Corinthian scripture, it said, thereby many are weak and sickly among you, and what many sleep. Amen. That was a troubling thought when I realized that I was talking to the believers. Well, he said, if we would judge ourselves, we should not be judged. But when we are judged, we are chastened of the Lord, that we should not be condemned with the world. Amen. We won't lose our salvation. You know, God got a way of dealing with stuff. Amen. If you're a believer, you don't deal with it, you don't want God to deal with it. Amen. Let us love one another. Cause no one to stumble. No, love don't want to see people stumble. Love don't want to see somebody falling. We get a kick out of it. Amen. This little analogy, we wrapping it up. The little girl said to the little boy, do you love me? The little boy said, yes, dear. The little girl said, would you die for me? The little boy said, no, mine is an undying love. That was pretty good. I like that. Anyway, amen. He loved it, but it's an undying love. And amen. But we thank God for Jesus. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish but have everlasting life. Amen. Tony Evans write, most people have birthmarks that are specific to them. I got a birthmark. Whether moles or other kinds of unique identification marks. Designers are known by their trademarks. They have logos of various kinds that even if you don't read the name, it becomes clear who made it. Amen. My kids like all the little stuff on their shirt. I ain't got one on this shirt. Yeah, that's a little man on there. Amen. Well, what's some of them out there? Well, anyway, that's not the issue. Amen. God established a mark on us, a very clear mark, by which his children who have been birthed